Good day to everyone. So today I will discuss to you the elements of fire. So in this topic, I will discuss to you the fuel element. So since the development of methods and tools for using and controlling fire was critical in human evolution, and is believed to have allowed early human to spread northward from the warm climate of either origin into the more severe environment of Europe and Asia. So, but today, fire is used as a source of warm and light and protection against enemies. And also, fire is used to provide processes for modifying chemicals into medicine. It provides heat to convert food materials, metals, and bones into domestic tools or instrument for aggression. While the application of fire has served man's needs, its careless and wanton use exacts an enormous and dreadful toll from society in life and property. So hence man's understanding of fire would enable him to develop the technology of prevention and control to considerable advanced state. So but first we need to know what is fire. So when we say fire, it is the manifestation of a rapid chemical reaction occurring between fuel and an oxidizer. So typically, the oxygen in the air is the oxidizer. So such rapid chemical reaction releases energy in the form of heat and light. So fire is heat and light resulting from the rapid combination of oxygen or in some cases, gaseous chlorine with other material. So the light is in the form of flame, which is composed of glowing particles of the burning material and certain gaseous products that are luminous at temperature of the burning material. So, next topic is the start of fire. Okay. So, all matters exist of one of the three states, which is the solid, liquid, and the gas or the gas vapor. So the atoms or molecules of the solid are packed closely together, and of a liquid is packed loosely. The molecules of a vapor are not packed together at all, and they are free to move about. So in order to for a substance to oxidize, its molecules must be pretty well surrounded by oxygen molecules. So the molecules of solids or liquids are too tightly packed to be surrounded, and thus only vapors can burn. And however, when a solid or liquid is heated, its molecules move about rapidly. If enough heat is applied, some molecules break away from the surface to form a vapor just above the substance. So this vapor can now mix with the oxygen if there is enough heat to raise the vapor to its ignition temperature or the temperature needed to burn. And if there is enough oxygen present, the vapor will oxidize rapidly and it will start to burn. Diyan po nagsisimula yung tinatawag nating fire. Okay. So the start of burning is the start of the chain reaction or the burning process. So vapor from the heated fuel rises, mixes with air and burns. So it produces enough heat to release more vapor and to draw into burn that vapor. So as more vapor burns, flames production increases and more heat is produced, more vapor release. So more air drawn into the flames and more vapor burns, and the chain reaction keeps increasing. So this is the size of the fire increases until the fuel is consumed. So when we say the chemistry of fire, there are three things to remember. We have the fuel, oxygen, and heat. So when we say fuel, this is the combustible materials to vaporize and burn. Okay. So the oxygen is the oxygen in the air is the common oxidizing agent to combine with fuel vapor. So air contains of 28% oxygen, 78% nitrogen, and 1% inert gas. And the last is the heat to raise the temperature of the fuel vapor to its ignition temperature. So the combination of these three elements form a so-called fire triangle. Okay. So if in the fire triangle, if any side of this is missing, a fire cannot start, or if any side of the fire triangle is removed, the fire will go off. With the presence of the elements of fire, combustion may take place. So before fuel will burn, it must be changed to its vapor states. So in a fire situation, this change usually result from the initial application of heat, and the process is known as the pyrolysis. So when we say pyrolysis, it is the thermal decomposition, okay? Or it is defined as the chemical decomposition of matter through the action of heat. Okay. So in the fire tetrahedron, the combustion process is better represented in this fire tetrahedron. Okay. The fire tetrahedron is useful in illustrating and remembering the combustion process because it has room for the chain reaction. And because of its phase touches the other three phases. So the basic difference of the fire triangle and the fire tetrahedron is that the tetrahedron illustrates how flaming combustion is supported and sustained through the chain reaction. So in this sense, the chain reaction phase keeps the other three phases from falling apart. So the fire tetrahedron also explains the flaming mode of combustion. So the modes of combustion are either flaming mode or a surface mode, or the glowing represented by the fire triangle. So this flaming mode of combustion, a condensed phase of combustion is called the glowing combustion. A gas phase combustion is known as the flame. And if the process is confined with pressure, it is called explosion. And if the combustion propagates at supersonic speed, it produces the what we call the detonation. So there are properties of fire. So first is the physical properties. So in the physical properties, we have the specific gravity, the vapor density, vapor pressure, temperature, boiling point, ignition or kindling temperature, fire point, and the flash point. In the specific gravity, the ratio of the weight of a solid or liquid substance to the weight of an equal volume of water. Okay. So when we say vapor density, it is the weight of a volume of pure gas composed of the volume of dry air at the same temperature and the pressure. While the vapor pressure, this is the force exerted by the molecules on the surface of a liquid. And the temperature, this is the measure of the degree of thermal agitation of molecules. And the boiling point, it is the constant temperature at which the vapor pressure of the liquid is equal to the atmospheric pressure. And the kindling or the ignition temperature, it is the minimum temperature at which the substance must be heated in order to initiate combustion. And fire point, it is the lowest temperature of a liquid in an open container at which vapors are evolved fast enough to support combustion. And the last one is the flash point, the temperature at which a flammable liquid forms a vapor air mixture that ignites. Okay, it is the mixture with the explosive range. To burn a fuel or a combustible material, its temperature must raise until ignition point is reached. Thus, before a fuel start to burn or before it can be ignited, it has to be exposed to a certain degree of temperature. So when the temperature of a certain substance is very high, it releases highly combustible vapors known as free radicals. So when we say free radicals, this is a combustible vapor such as the hydrogen gas, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, and oxygen. Okay. So during the process of pyrolysis, so the following are involved, because when we say pyrolysis or the thermal decomposition, okay, the fuel is heated until its temperature reaches its fire point. So pyrolysis decomposition takes place. Moisture in the fuel is converted into vapor. And decomposition is produces combustible vapors that rise to the surface of the fuel or the free radicals. And the last one is free radicals undergo combustion. Okay, so as you can see in this process, this is the wood. You can see the wood, the unburned part. So when we say the pyrolysis, dito nagsimula, and the char and the ash. This is the process of pyrolysis. Okay. So under the properties of fire is the chemical properties. We have the endothermic reactions, exothermic reactions, the oxidations, and the flame. So when we say endothermic reaction, the changes whereby energy or the heat is absorbed or is added before the reaction takes place. And the exothermic reaction, those that release or give off energy or heat, thus they produce a substance with less energy than the reactants. And the oxidation, a chemical change that is exothermic. So a change in which combustible material or the fuel and an oxidizing agent, the air, react. So example of oxidation is combustion, which is the same as actual burning or the rapid oxidation. So the flames are the incandescent or very bright, glowing with the intense heat gases. It is a combination, or it is a combustion product and a manifestation of fire when it is in its gas phase. So there are types of flames. So based on the color and completeness of combustibility of fuel, we have the luminous flame and the non-luminous flame. So when we say luminous flame, it is an orange red, okay, deposit soot at the bottom of a vessel being heated due to incomplete combustion and has a low temperature. Okay, while the non-luminous flame, it is blue. There is complete combustion of fuel and has a relatively high temperature. When we say, as you can see in the example, ito yung non-luminous flame, it is color blue. Okay. So another one is based on the fuel and air mixture. So we have the premix flame and the diffusion flame. So in the premix flame, it is exemplified by a Bunsen type laboratory burner where hydrocarbon or any substance containing primary carbon and the hydrogen is thoroughly mixed with the air before reaching the flame zone. And the diffusion flame is observed when gas or the fuel alone is forced through a nozzle into the atmosphere, which diffuse in the surrounding atmosphere in order to form a flammable mixtures. So the candle flame is an example of a diffusion flame governed purely by molecular diffusion, and the flame of the oxyacetylene torch, okay, or the when we say diffuse, it is the disperse or widely spread. Okay, and the other one is based on smoothness. So when we say we have the laminar flame and turbulent flame, when we say laminar flame, when a particle follows a smooth path through a gaseous flame, and the turbulent flame are those having an steady regular flows. As physical size, the gas density or velocity is increased, all laminar gas flows tend to become turbulent. Okay. So these are the fire elements. We have the fuel, heat, and the oxygen. Okay. So I will now discuss the fuel element. Okay. So fuels or the combustible materials is a matter exists in three physical states. We have the solid, liquid, and the gas. So solid melts to become liquids, and this may vaporize and become gases. So the basic rule is that at high enough temperature, all fuels can be converted to gases, and each of the physical states exhibit different physical and chemical properties that directly affect the fuel's combustibility. So for example, is the gasoline, as a liquid, does not burn. It is the vapors rising from the liquid that burn. Okay. So likewise, wood, the most common solid fuel, is not flammable but gives off flammable vapors, the what we call the free radicals. So fuel is also a material that provides useful energy. So fuels are used to heat and cook food, power engines, and produce electricity. And some fuels occurs naturally and others are artificially created. So ano yung mga artificially created na yan? So such as the natural gases, natural fuels, I should say. And these are the coals, petroleum, and natural gases obtained from underground deposit that were 4 million years ago from the remains of plants and animals. So they are called fossil fuels, okay, which account for about 90% of the energy people use today. Okay. So also we have the synthetic fuels can be made from fossil fuels, certain types of rock and the sun and the biomass. So most fuels release energy from by burning with the oxygen in the air. But some, especially chemical fuels used in rockets, need special oxidizers in order to burn. And the nuclear fuels do not burn but release energy through the fission or the what we call splitting of fusion, okay, or the joining together of atoms. Okay, so In the classification of combustible materials, we have the class A fuel, B, C, D, and K fuels. So the class A fuels, they are ordinary combustible material that are usually made of organic substance, okay, such as the wood and the wood-based products. And it includes some synthetic or inorganic material like rubber, leather, and the plastic products. Okay. And the class B fuels, these are materials that are in the form of flammable liquids such as alcohol, acidic solution, oil, liquid, petroleum products, and etc. And the class C fuels, they are normally fire-resistant materials, such as materials used on electrical wiring and other electrical appliances. Okay, class C is the fires involving energized electrical equipment. And class D, they are combustible metallic substances which as magnesium, titanium, zirconium, sodium, and potassium. These are fires involving combustible metals. Okay, nakikita niyo yung magnesium, sodium, potassium, titanium, aluminum. Okay. So, and special dry powder extinguishing agents are required for this class of fire. Okay, and the last one is the class K. Fires involving commercial cooking appliances with vegetable oils, animal oils, or fats at high temperatures. So, these are the classification of combustible materials. So, the general categories of fuels is the solid, liquid, and gaseous fuels, substances. So, the solid combustible materials, these are the organic and inorganic, natural or synthetic, and metallic solid materials. The liquid combustible materials includes the flammable liquids, the fuels and chemicals, and the gaseous substances. It includes those toxic or hazardous gases that are capable of ignitions. So, what are the types of flammable solid? Okay. In the solid fuels, the most obvious solid fuels are wood, paper, and cloth. So its burning rate depends on the on its configuration. So for example, solid fuels in the form of dust will burn faster than bulky materials. Okay. So the types of flammable solid is the pyrolyzable solid fuels and the non-pyrolyzable solid fuels. So when we say pyrolyzable solid fuels, it includes many of the ordinary accepted combustibles such as the wood paper and so on. So the vapor released by their chemical decomposition support flaming combustion. This exemplifies a gas-to-gas reaction. The vapors release mix with oxygen in air and to produce a flame. While the non-pyrolyzable solid fuels, these are solid fuels that are difficult to ignite. So a common example is charcoal or yung uling. So chemical decomposition does not occur because there are no pyrolyzable elements present. So no vapors are released. And the glowing combustion that result is an example of gas to solid reaction. Okay, so there are a group of solid fuel. So these are the following: we have the biomass, fabric and textile, plastics, coal, and the peat. So I will discuss to you first the biomass. So it is the name given to such replaceable organic matters like wood, garbage, and animal manure that can be used to produce energy. So for example is the heat produced by burning nutshells, rice, and oat hulls and other byproducts of food processing they are often used to operate plant equipment. Okay, so there are factors affecting the combustibility of wood and wood-based products. We have the physical form, moisture content, the heat conductivity, rate and period of heating, rate of combustion, and the ignition pressure. So in the physical form, the smaller the piece of wood, the easier it is to burn. Okay? Pag mas maliit daw yung kahoy, mas madaling masunog. While the moisture content or the water content, the freshly cut wood is more difficult to ignite and burn than dry wood. Siyempre naman, pag basa yung kahoy, mas mahirap masunog. And the heat conductivity, a poor conductor of heat takes a longer time to ignite than those materials that are good conductors of heat. Okay? The rate and period of heating, less flammable materials don't easily ignite and needs direct contact with flame than highly combustible materials. While in the rate of combustion, with an unlimited supply of oxygen, the rate of burns increases, more heat is produced, and the fuel is consumed more completely. And the ignition pressure, this is ignition temperature, not ignition pressure. The higher the temperature, the faster it reaches ignition point. And it varies depending on the other factors like the physical form, moisture, heat rate, and the period of heating and rate of combustion. So the next is the fabrics and the textiles. So in the fabric and textiles, almost all fibers and the textiles are combustible. So a fiber is a very fine thin strand or thread-like object. And the fabrics are twisted or woven fibers. And textiles are machine woven or knitted fabric. So the classification of fibers, okay? So we have the natural fibers and the synthetic or the artificial fibers. So when we say natural fibers, they come from plants, from coconut fiber, cotton, acid fiber, pulp, or the wood fiber. So from animals, we have the wool, silk, protein fibers. Ito yung mga tinatawag nating leather. And from minerals, kalimitan is yung asbestos. While the synthetic or artificial fibers, these are organic fibers, okay, cellulose fibers, cellulose acetate, non-cellulose, and inorganic fibers like the fiberglass or steel, mang bakal. So there are factors affecting the combustibility of fibers. So we have the chemical composition. So in the chemical composition, the natural and synthetic organic fibers are generally highly combustible materials, especially if they are dry. So the mineral fibers and synthetic inorganic fibers are normally fire resistant materials. So next is the fiber finish or coating. So fiber coating combined with the organic fibers that are supportive to continue the burning of fabric. Next is the fabric weight. The heavier the fabric, the greater is its resistance to ignition, thus delaying its ignition. The tightness of weave. Okay, the closer the fiber are woven, the smaller the space it contains. Thus, it takes a longer period to ignite it. And the flame retardant treatment, this is a fabric treated with the flame retardant and have a higher resistance to ignition. Okay. So, in the fabric ignition, meron kasi tayong tinatawag na limiting oxygen index or the LOI. When we say LOI, it is a numerical basis of measuring the tendency of a fabric to continuously burn once source of ignition is removed. Okay. So if the LOI of the fabric is high, the probability that it will cease to burn once the flame is removed is also high, and the fabric with high LOI and the high ignition temperature are safer for clothing and furnishing because they do not ignite easily. So also they do not continue burning after the source of heat or flame is removed. Kaya mayroon nga tayong mga tela na fire resistant. Okay, as you can see in this example, okay, we have the polyvinyl chloride flame resistant. Okay, as you can see, the LOI is very high. So it means to say that the burning or the ignition is hindi siya madaling masunog. Okay. Kumbaga, it is safer yung mas mataas yung LOI. Okay. As you compare to the LOI of cotton, it is only 18 to 21, and the ignition temperature is 390. As you can see, the ease of ignition is burns easily, while the polyvinyl is flame resistant. Okay. So next is the plastics. Okay. So in the plastic, included as ordinary fuels under class A, except those materials or containing cellulose nitrate. So cellulose nitrate is a chemical powder used in bombs. So they are also called pyroxylene. So the plastic comprised of a group of materials consisting mainly of organic substances or high molecular substances. They are solid in the finished state, although at some stages of manufacture, plastics can be made to flow into a desired shape, usually through the application of heat or pressure or both. Okay. Yan yung mga plastic na ginagamit natin, or yung mga pinaglalagyan ng mga soft drinks. Okay, next is the coal. So when we say the coal, it is a black combustible mineral solid resulting from the partial decomposition of matter under varying degrees of temperature. So they are used as fuels in the production of coal gas, water gas, and many coal compounds. And they are also used to heat buildings and to provide energy for industrial machinery. So the forms of coals are lignite or brown coal. Ito, lignite. Okay. Bituminous coal, the bituminous coal, and the anthracite. So bituminous coal is the most plentiful and important coal used by industry. It contains more carbon and produces more heat than either lignite or sub-bituminous coal. So it is also the coal best suited for making coke. Okay. The anthracite is the least plentiful, okay, and the hardest coal. It contains more carbon and produces more heat than other coal. So, however, the anthracite is difficult to ignite and burns slowly. Okay. And the other one is peat. Okay. It is a partially decayed plant matter found in swamps called the bugs and used as a fuel chiefly in areas where coal and oil are scarce. So ginagamit yan sa mga lugar na hindi gaanong marami ang coal and oil. So in Ireland and Scotland, for example, peat is cut formed in blocks and dried. So the dried blocks are then burned to heat homes. Okay. This is the example of peat. Okay. So yung peat na yan, dito nanggagaling yung anthracite. This is the process. Okay. Yung mga fossil deposits. Okay? Nagsimula sa peat, then nagiging peat, nagiging lignite, then nagiging sub-bituminous, then nagiging bituminous, then nagiging anthracite. Pero matagal bago mas siya maging anthracite. Okay? So next is the liquid fuels. In the liquid fuels, these are mainly made from petroleum. Okay, but some synthetic liquids are also produced. So petroleum is also called as crude oil. Okay, they may be refined to produce gasoline, diesel oil, and kerosene. So other fuel oils obtained by refining petroleum to distillate oil and residual oils. So when we say distillate oils, these are light oils which are used chiefly to heat homes and small buildings. Okay. While the residual oils are heavy and used to provide energy to power utilities, factories, and large ships. Okay. So in the process or the oil-based paint products are also highly flammable liquids, release vapors in much the same way as the solid fuels. So the rate of in the process of vaporization, flammable liquids releases vapor in much the same way as solid fuels. So the rate vapor is greater for liquids than solids. So since liquids have less closely packed molecules, so in addition, liquids can release vapor over the wide range. For example, the gasoline starts to give vapor at 4 degrees Celsius or 45 degrees Fahrenheit. So this makes gasoline a continuous fire hazard. So it produces flammable vapor at normal temperature. Okay. So what are the characteristics or general characteristics of liquids? So liquid fuels, they are matters with a definite volume but no definite shape. Okay. They assume the shape of the vessel because there is free movement of molecules, and they are slightly compressible. So they are not capable of indefinite expansion unlike gas. So the two general groups of liquid fuels are the flammable liquids and combustible liquids. So in the flammable liquids, they are liquids having a flash point of 37.8 degrees Celsius or 100 degrees Fahrenheit and a vapor pressure not exceeding 40 PSIA, okay, at 37.8 degrees Celsius. While the combustible liquids, these are liquids have a plus point at or above 37.8 degrees Celsius or 100 degrees Fahrenheit. So these are example of flammable liquids and the combustible liquids. So in the flammable, we have isopropyl alcohol, propane, solvents, okay, fuels like gasoline, kerosene, and aerosols. While the combustible liquids, oil, greases, and lubricants, or oil-based paints. Okay. So the burning characteristics of liquids, since it is the vapors from the flammable liquid which burn, The case of ignition as well as the rate of burning can be related to the physical properties such as the vapor pressure, the flash point, boiling point, and the evaporation rate. So the liquids having vapors in the flammable range above the liquid surface at the stored temperature have rapid rate of flame propagation. And the liquids having a flash point above stored temperature have slower rate of flame propagation. So the chemical explanation is it is necessary for the fire to heat sufficiently the liquid surface to form flammable vapor air moisture before the flame will spread through the vapor. Okay. So what are the factors affecting the rate of flame propagation and burning of liquids? Okay, so we have the wind velocity, the temperature, heat combustion, latent heat of evaporation, and the atmospheric pressures. These are the factors affecting the rate of flame propagation and burning of liquids. So when we say the latent heat, it is the quantity of heat absorbed by a substance from a solid to a liquid and from a liquid to gas. Conversely, heat is released during conversion of a gas to liquid or liquid to a solid. Okay. So next is the gas fuels. So gaseous fuels are those in which molecules are in rapid movement and random motions. They are no they have no definite shape or volume, and assume the shape and volume of their container. So there are both natural and manufactured flammable gases. So gas fuels flow easily through pipes and are used to provide energy for homes, businesses, and industries. So examples of gas fuels are acetylene, propane, and butanes. So some properties of gas fuels are compressibility, okay, expandability, permeability, or the what we call open to passage or penetration, diffusion, or the intermingling of molecules. So when we say compressibility or expandability, it refers to the potential in changes in volume. While diffusion in the is the uniform distribution of molecules of one substance through those of another. And the permeability means that other substances may pass through or permeate a gas. Okay. So the characteristic of gas fuels, so they are matters that have no different shape. They are composed of very tiny particles, such ito yung tinatawag nating molecules, at constant random motion in a straight line. And gas molecules collide against one another and against the wall of the container and are relatively far from one another. So there are classification of gases. So based on a source, we have natural gas and manufactured gas. So in natural gas, these are gas used to heat buildings, cook food, and provides energy for industries. So it consists chiefly of methane. When you say methane, a colorless and odorless gas. So natural gas is usually mixed with compounds of foul-smelling elements like sulfur. Okay, sulfur gas and so gas leaks can be detected, and butane and propane, which make up a small proportion of natural gas, it becomes liquid when placed under a large amount of pressure. So when pressure is released, they change back to gas. So an example of this butane and propane is this so-called the liquefied petroleum gas, or the LPG, or the liquefied natural gas. Okay, these are easily stored and shipped as liquid. Okay. And the manufactured gas, this gas like synthetic liquid fuels is used chiefly where certain fuels are abundant and others are scarce, like the coal, petroleum, and biomass can all be converted to gas through heating and various chemical procedures. So next is according to physical properties, which we have the compressed gas, the liquefied gas, and the cryogenic. Okay. The compressed gas, which at all normal temperature inside its container, exists solely in the gaseous state under pressure. So the pressure depends on the pressure to which the container is originally charged and how much gas remains in the container. Okay. However, temperature affects the volume and pressure of the liquid gas. So the liquefied gas, gas which at normal temperature inside the, its container exists partly in the liquid state and partly in gaseous state and under pressure as long as any liquid remains in the container. So the pressure basically depends on the temperature of the liquid, although the amount of liquid also affect the pressure under some condition. So a liquefied gas exhibits a more complicated behavior as a result of heating. And the last one is the cryogenic gas, a liquefied gas which exists in its container at temperature far below normal atmospheric temperature, usually slightly above its boiling point and correspondingly low to moderate pressure. Example of this cryogenic gas are air, carbon monoxide, ethylene, fluorine, helium, hydrogen, methane, nitrogen, and oxygen. These are all example of cryogenic gas. According to usage, we have the fuel gases, industrial gases, and medical gases. So in the fuel gases, flammable gases usually used for burning with air to produce heat, utilized as power, light, comfort, and process. Most commonly used gases are natural gas and the LPG, the butane and the propane. The industrial gases, this group includes a large number of gases used for industrial processes as those in welding and cutting. Sa welding and cutting, meron tayong oxygen and acetylene. Sa refrigeration, meron tayong tinatawag na freon, ammonia, and sulfur dioxide. While the chemical processing, we have hydrogen, nitrogen, ammonia, and chlorine. And the water treatment, we have chlorine and fluorine. While the medical gases, those used for treatment such as the anesthesia, the what we call chloroform nitrous oxide, and the respiratory therapy or the oxygen. Okay. So next is the burning of gaseous fuels. So the gaseous fuels are already in the required vapor state. Only the proper intermix with the oxygen and sufficient heat is needed for ignition. So gases like flammable liquids always produce a visible flame and they do not smolder. Okay. So the next is the chemical fuels. So chemical fuels which are produced in solid and liquid form, it creates great amounts of heat and power. So they are used chiefly in rocket engines. So chemical fuels, a chemical rocket propellant consists of both a fuel and an oxidizer. So the common rocket fuel is the hydrazine, the chemical hydrazine. The oxidizer is the oxidizer is a substance such as the nitrogen tetroxide that contains oxygen. So when the propellant is ignited, the oxidizer provides the oxygen fuel. The fuel needs to burn. And the chemical fuels are also used in some racing cars. Okay. And the nuclear fuels, these nuclear fuels provide energy through the fission and fusion of their atoms. So uranium is the most commonly used nuclear fuel, though plutonium also provides nuclear energy. So when the atoms of these elements undergo fission, they release tremendous amount of heat. Okay, so nuclear fuels are used mainly to generate electricity. They also power some submarines and ships. Okay. Nuclear energy can also produce through the fusion of hydrogen atoms. So when we say nuclear fission, this is the split of the nucleus of atoms. And the nuclear fusion, it is a combination of two light nuclei atoms. So yung nuclear fuels natin, for example, ito yung ginagamit ng mga aircraft carrier ng United States, na kung saan hindi na sila naglalagay ng mga fuels. Okay. Kahit na ilang taon sa dagat yan, hindi na kailangan ng mga gasolina because of that nuclear or diesel because of that nuclear fuel. So that is the coverage of the solid fuels. Okay. So the next topic is the heat element. Okay, the heat element and the oxygen as an oxidizing agent. Okay, so thank you and God bless.